if we can stay the course, hallelujah, stay on our knees, stay on our faith, stay in the word of God, God is going to bring us out
more than conquerors.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
So no.
Don't talk
this thing to me.
Don't do it.
Amen. Don't talk it to me. You can take it to somebody else, but I've grown beyond that.
Thank you, Jesus.
Anybody in here with me?
Thank you, Jesus.
I've grown beyond talking defeat.
Jesus.
I know that thanks be to God, He gives us the victory. Anybody in here got the victory?
Amen.
Come on, shout, I have the victory.
I have the victory.
No, that wasn't a shout. Shout, I have the victory.
I have the victory.
Anybody in here got an impossible situation? Shout, I have the victory.
I have the victory.
Looks like it's not going to get any better. Say, I have the victory.
I have the victory.
Taken already, given up and counted you out. Shout, I have the victory.
I have the victory. Yes.
I need to shout it today. I need to shout it from the rooftop. I need to shout it from this pulpit. We declare victory.
Today.
We don't have to declare war. Hallelujah. For the battle is not mine. It belongs to the Lord.
Yep.
So He declares war.
Right.
All I've got to do is stand still and do what?
See
the salvation of the Lord. Anybody ready to stand still?
Yes.
Come on, stand in your place right now and see what God is getting ready to do. See how God is getting ready to bring you out. See what God is able to do. See that God has given you the victory. Get up and stand in your victory.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
I feel God this morning. Y'all should push me. Now that you push me, I'm going to preach.
All right. Use the Lord.
Let me tell you one thing about the devil. He has no power, y'all.
None.
He can't do nothing. Is there anybody in this room? It looks bad. Yes, it looks bad because we're looking through our natural eyes. We're looking at the seen things. But the unseen things are what we should be trying to get in contact with.
Yes.
For now, faith is.
Mm-hmm.
The substance of things hoped for.
Jesus.
I tell you, God is in this house.
Yes, He is.
Amen. Amen. I got my war clothes on this morning.
Yes.
I knew it was going to be a fight, children. I knew it was going to be a fight when Sister Sissy called and she was going through.
Jesus.
And then Sister called me and she was going through. And I was talking over now and she was going through. And Brother was going through. And all of Victory's people, all of those of us who are in the shift.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Did anybody hear what I said?
Yes.
I said we are in the shift.
In the shift.
And
thank
while you're
Lord.
In the shift, some things got to drop off.
That's Amen. Right. That's right.
Telling the truth.
Is there anybody in here?
Yes.
Amen. And so God is purging us.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank God.
Purging us. And as He purges us, it doesn't feel comfortable. Amen. Anybody ever amen, worked on a flower and tried to make it come back to life?
All right.
And so you have to cut this little piece off. And you got to pull this little thing off. And you got to dump some water on it. And you got to do all these things so that you can see the growth that you want to see.
Yes.
That's what God is doing to us.
Thank
Why?
You,
because
Thank
we're
God.
In the shift. Yeah, because we're about to hit the level that God wants us to be
Thank
at.
Thank you, Lord.
Now, as we go to this new level, we have new enemies.
That's right. That's right.
We have new devils.
Jesus. In form.
Yes.
Is there anybody in here?
Yeah.
Can I share something? I won't share the whole thing, but I'll share some of it. Then I'm going to give you this word. I had a couple of prophetic words. Some of the prophetesses of the house, they were sharing. Amen. And some of the things that I didn't know. I didn't know the symbolism of certain things. But one of the sisters said that she had a dream. It was a vision. It was not a dream. It was a vision. She was sitting on the edge of her bed. And in the church, in Victory, there was an alligator.
Mm-hmm.
In Victory, an alligator was in Victory. And we, the church, was outside. But the alligator was inside victory. And the symbolism of an alligator is somebody who spreads deceit.
Jesus.
That's the Leviathan. The spirit of Leviathan. And she saw that in the vision, and they were spreading deceit and spreading lies and spreading different things. And in came a warrior.
Thank you, Lord.
The church was still outside and we were looking in, but God sent a warrior.
Thank you, Lord.
And when he sent the warrior shut the mouth of the alligator. Amen. Yes. And she said there may be some residual from it, but the dream ended with victory, having the victory.
Amen. 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 Thank God.
Another one of the prophetess called me this week. She said, Bishop, I saw in a dream that some of the old members have returned to worship.
Jesus.
Amen. The Lord was sending back some of the old members, and they were coming back to worship with the church. And the spirit of prophecy fell on Sister Taylor.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. And I'm saying to myself, on Sister Taylor, but that's what God does.
That's right.
God uses the foolish things. Sister Taylor's not foolish, but the unusual.
That's right. That's
so
right.
So that we can know what? That is God.
Amen.
Not us.
That's right. Amen. Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Why are you saying this, Bishop? We know that the victory is already ours.
Yes,
already. But the enemy is sending all kinds of things to make us lose our focus.
Uh-huh.
But I'm not going to lose my focus.
That's right.
I'm not going to give in to what the devil is trying to show us.
Nope.
Some folks, their relationships are all messed up, and some folks' finances are all messed up, and just calls after calls after calls. But I said, I'm going to stay right here because I'm going to see what I've been praying
for. Lord. Yes, Lord. I'm going to see it.
Is there anybody with me today?
I'm going to see it.
I'm not going to look at what the devil wants me to look at. I've been praying for health.
Yeah.
I've been praying for healing.
Yeah.
I've been praying for finances.
Amen.
I've been praying for my family to be saved. I've been praying for folk to come into the kingdom.
Yes.
And that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for the things that I'm not seeing now. Is there anybody in this house?
Yes.
We can't look at what the devil is doing. He's desperate.
Yes. He's desperate.
Amen.
Jesus.
Come on.
This is our time.
Yes.
Yes, it is.
This is our season.
Oh, yeah.
And we're moving to a new level.
Thank God.
Is there anybody in here?
Amen.
Anybody?
Yes, Bishop.
Clap your hands.
Amen.
And so the Lord said that he has something better.
Thank you, God.
Wow.
Amen. That's the message for today. Something better.
Something better.
Thank you, Lord. Amen. In the book of Hebrews. I'm going to begin at the 11th chapter. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
And at the 32nd verse. Thank you, Sister Medina. That's just what we needed.
Amen. Yes.
Thank God.
Hebrews, the 11th chapter, beginning at verse 32. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen.
And what more shall I say? For the time would fail me to tell of Gideon and Barak and Samson and Jephthah and also of David and Samuel and the prophets, who through faith subdued kingdoms, worked righteousness, obtained promises, stopped the mouths of lions, quenched the violence of fire, escaped the edge of the sword, out of weakness were made strong, became valiant in battle, turned to flight the armies of the aliens. Women received their dead raised to life again. Others were tortured, not accepting deliverance, that they might obtain a better resurrection. Still, others had trial of mockings and scourgings, yes, and of chains and imprisonment. They were stoned, they were sawn in two, were tempted, were slain with the sword. They wandered about in sheepskins and goatskins, being destitute, afflicted, tormented, of whom the world was not worthy. They wandered in deserts and mountains and dens and caves of the earth. And all these, having obtained a good testimony through faith, did not receive the promise. God, having provided something better for us, that they should not be made perfect apart from us. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
You may be seated. Something better.
Something
Amen.
Better.
Something better. The book of Hebrews is what we call an epistle, a letter. It was written mainly to the Hebrew believers. The author is anonymous, although either Paul or Barnabas was traditionally accepted as the author. It was written approximately 67 AD. Its purpose was to present the Lord Jesus Christ as perfect and superior in comparison to anything Judaism and the Old Covenant had to offer. The author was writing to a group of Christians who were under intense persecution. Some of us are under some persecution right now. And some were contemplating a return to Judaism. Paul, he admonished them not to turn away from their only hope of salvation. Amen?
Amen.
Hebrews chapter 11 is often called the Hall of Faith. In this chapter, the writer introduces an impressive list of heroic figures mm-hmm. from the Old Testament.
Mm-hmm.
Remarkable men and women whose stories stand out to encourage and challenge our faith. Some of these heroes of the Bible were well-known personalities, while others remain anonymous. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Something better. Amen. When you read the book of Hebrews, amen, the 11th chapter, you will see many familiar names. And you will see the different hardships that they went through. It wasn't like they just went through some simple headaches, or they went through some simple relationship breakups, or they lost their job. They were in life and death situations. Amen. And when you begin to read about them, and you see how God delivered them even through death. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The scripture tells us that even though they went through these hardships, amen, Moses and Noah and Rahab, who was a harlot, amen, as you see in the 11th chapter of Hebrews,
mm-hmm.
God chose so many of the heroes of the Bible, but some of them had some suspect backgrounds.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
They were not perfect mm-hmm. individuals. Amen. Like we would consider them to be perfect. But you don't have to be perfect for God to use
Amen.
You.
Amen.
May I say that?
Yes, okay. You can.
Amen. Sometimes we get it wrong and folks begin to say, I'll come to church when I can do this right. Mm-hmm. Or I'll come to church when I lay down my cigarettes or when I stop drinking. But you know, a lot of times you can't lay it down on your own.
That's right.
You can't stop drinking on your own. No. You can't stop running around. You need to be around people who were able to do it.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
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 You need to be around folk who had made up their mind that that was not going to control them any longer.
That's right.
And when you see that God was able to let them break free, you get the courage Amen. To at least try to break free. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Those people in the Bible, David, we know about David. Everybody in here know that David has some issues.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
David did some terrible things. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. But God loved David and God used
That's
David.
That's right.
Amen. Rahab was a prostitute.
Yes, she was.
Amen. But she did something right.
Yes.
Amen. She recognized the men of God.
That's right.
Amen. And even when you begin to recognize the men of God, the women of God, God can do something in your life.
That's right.
Can I get a witness? Sometimes you don't always turn from your wicked ways right in the beginning. But if you can just acknowledge that she's a woman of God, if you can just acknowledge that this is a true house of God, if you can just acknowledge what God is doing, God can do something in your life. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. All of these people, they went through Christ had not yet come, so that they had not accepted Christ as their personal Savior. Mm-hmm. But what they did have, they believed God.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen, Bishop.
When I wrote on last week, I said, I believe God. And I do. I believe God. No matter what I'm going through, people of God,
I believe God.
If it's hard and it seems like I'm not going to come out of this, I still believe God.
Yes.
Can I get a witness? Yes. Amen. If it doesn't turn out the way I want it to turn out, I still believe God. Yes. Even if my body never gets healed,
I still believe God.
I believe God is who God says He is.
I believe
that God can do what God says He can do.
Yes.
I wish I could get an amen.
Yes. I believe God.
Amen. And because I believe God, and that can be imputed to me as righteousness. Can I get a witness? Amen. The saints of old, it was imputed to them. If they believed God, as they followed God, as we read the scriptures, as we saw the heroes of faith, we found out they didn't do so many heroic things. Moses did something that displeased God, but he was still a hero of the faith.
Yes.
Sometimes we want to dot every I and cross every T, and then we forget about the weightier things.
Yes.
We forget that we still got to love everybody.
Still.
We still got to walk by faith
still.
And not by sight.
Yes.
Is there anybody in there? We're so busy not fornicating. We're so busy not drinking alcohol.
Jesus.
We forget that we got to love our neighbor as ourselves.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen. All of these heroes of the Bible, we know about Jonah. Jonah was a mess. I'm going to say it again.
Say it again.
Jonah was a mess. He didn't want to do the will of God. How many of us in here have tried to run from God?
All right. Tell the truth.
God would tell us to prophesy, and we say, I don't want to because the people won't listen to me. Amen. Didn't Moses say that? Said, if I went and told them, who's going to listen to me? But they're not listening to you.
Amen.
They're not listening to you. Ain't nobody going to listen to you.
That's nobody.
But if you got a word from the Lord,
all right.
And God put a word in your mouth, if God gives you an assignment and tell you to go to sister and tell sister, even though sister don't want to hear it, sister will have to hear. Why? Because it's prepared for her to hear.
Thank you, Lord.
All of these guys, they did great things. Even though Noah, glory be to God, built the ark, he was made a fool of.
Uh-huh.
Slept with his daughters.
Anybody here?
Amen.
But they call them heroes of the faith.
Yes.
David was a hero of the faith, but he killed Uriah.
Yes, right.
He killed Uriah because he slept with Uriah's wife.
That's right.
And got Bathsheba pregnant.
That's right.
But he was a man after God's own heart. Why? Because he believed God. God will show us over and over again, Alex, that just believing, hallelujah. Remember the thief on the cross, everybody?
Yeah.
He was no good.
No good.
He lived a no good life. He got caught.
Yes.
He was being crucified. But at the last minute, he believed God.
He believed.
Come on
he
now.
He believed that Jesus Christ was the Son of the living God. I wish I could preach it the way I feel it.
Preach.
He believed it so much. He says, you have a kingdom. When you get there, remember me.
Yes.
Amen.
Remember me.
Let me tell you something. God has something better for us.
Yes, he does.
Amen.
Amen.
He has prepared a better way for us. The Bible said in all their believing and all that they suffered through, they didn't throw up their hands and give up. Amen.
Amen.
They didn't say, I can't do it no more.
Right.
That this is too hard for me.
Right.
They didn't curse God to his face.
Right.
And the hits just kept on coming. Job, hallelujah. Hallelujah, poor Job.
Poor
but
Job.
He went through, but he stood his ground. Can I get a witness?
Yes, you can.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
But he
Yes, Lord.
I didn't have cancer in my body, but I'm going to dance.
Yes.
I'm going to dance. I'm going to give God the praise.
Yes, Lord.
Why? Because I trust God.
Yes,
I believe God.
I trust God. I believe God.
Jesus, yes, Lord.
I love God, yes.
He has something better for us.
Something better.
Even though folk walk away.
Mm-hmm.
And in this line, baby, folk are going to walk away. Could you hear what I say?
Yes, Bishop.
Husbands will walk away from wives. Children will walk away from parents. Friends will say, we are not going down the same road any longer. People will walk away from you.
Yes, they
will. But when you trust God and you believe God and you stand on the word of God, God will allow you to have the victory every time.
Again and again.
Amen. Amen.
He has a better way for us. The Bible said that the heroes of faith, they suffered through these things. The Bible said that they had to wear sheep skin. Why? Because they were on the run. Why? Because they were being persecuted. And they had to find some place to live. The Bible said they hid in caves. Hallelujah. They hid in dens. Glory be to God. Why? Because they believed God. The more we believe God, the hotter it's going to get, everybody. The more we believe in God to do it for us, the enemy is going to try to blind your eyes. Is there anybody in here?
Him.
He provided for us, Sister Althea, a better way.
Yes.
Listen to me, Sister Jillian. The Bible says that Jesus came to put children against parents. And
that's right.
Our children are meant to rise up against us. Why? Because if they're not doing what they're supposed to do, they're going to rise up against us.
Amen.
But the Bible said, don't worry about it. When you open up your mouth, I'm going to tell you what to say in that hour.
Amen.
Somebody shout, I believe God.
I believe God.
See, I know you don't believe God.
I believe God.
Say you believe God.
I believe God.
Tell somebody you believe God.
I believe God.
I believe God.
I believe God.
God, you believe God.
I believe God. I believe you, Lord.
No matter what we're going through, we've got to stand on that. Yes. That I believe God.
Amen.
If God said it, I believe it.
Yes.
If God said it, he will bring it to pass.
Yes, he will.
Can I get a witness? Uh-huh. I may look like a fool to everybody.
Jesus.
But if God said it, I'd rather look like a fool to you than be disobedient to the voice of the Lord.
Yes.
Somebody shout, I believe God.
I believe God.
Yes.
The Bible said that they had to run from place to place to find safety. God has not permitted that for us. Many of us have some stability in our homes.
Thank God.
But that does not mean that we're not being persecuted.
All right.
I feel the preacher on the inside of me.
Amen.
Elder Belinda, the scripture tells me I can be troubled on every side.
Every side.
Has anybody ever been there?
Jesus.
Oh, my Savior, my God.
Jesus.
I've been troubled on every side.
On every
but the Bible
side.
Said what? Not distressed.
Thank
Amen.
You.
Amen. Sometimes we get all bent out of shape because the enemy comes up against us like a flood.
Yes.
But if we get the word of God, look at your neighbor and say, get the word.
Get the word.
Even though he comes up against us, the Bible says if we're in the water, he'll be there.
Yes.
If we're in the fire,
he'll be there.
Can I get a witness somebody?
Thank you, Lord.
No matter where I go, no matter what I'm going through, the Lord is there.
Yes.
He will bring me out more than a conqueror.
Yes.
Who's a conqueror today?
Yes.
Who's an overcomer today? Who is triumphant
Yes, God.
I'm not going to fight the devil no more.
Nope. No more.
No more. No more.
Why, Alex? Because he's already defeated.
Already.
Yes.
Already.
The Bible didn't say fight him.
Nope.
Says resist him.
And he will flee. Got to go.
I ain't fighting him no more. Why? Because he's a spirit.
Yes, Lord.
I can't hit him.
Jesus.
I can't spit on him.
Nope.
The Bible said resist him. But the Bible did tell us to get into the fight. Says the fight. The good fight.
Of faith.
Anybody in here with me? Faith is the thing you've got to contend with.
Why? Because sometimes our faith gets bogged down.
That's right. That's right.
Sometimes things are just aggravating us so much. Hallelujah. And we want to give up, throw up our hands, and go back into the world. Go back and doubt God. Go back and sit down. But you got to keep your dukes up when it comes to the faith of God. You got to remind yourself, I believe.
That's right.
And can I tell you something else, people of God?
Mm-hmm.
We all have to remind ourselves.
Yeah. We all.
Because I'm a bishop don't mean that there are not days I have to tell myself, you better believe God.
Uh-huh.
You better trust God.
Amen.
Anybody in here with me?
Amen.
Because we have a title don't mean that we don't feel.
That's right.
Every once in a while I gotta tell myself, Bishop. Yes. I gotta check myself, Bishop.
Uh-huh. Yes, Lord.
Why? Because stuff happens.
That's right.
Is there anybody in here?
That's right.
Life happens.
Right.
Circumstances happen.
Mm-hmm.
And we feel them.
Yes.
And when we feel them, we can either say, Lord, I trust you, or this is just too much.
That's right.
Well, I've chosen in this season to say, Lord, I trust you.
Amen. Lord, I trust
Amen.
You.
Lord, I believe you.
Amen.
He has something better for us. The scripture says that all of those heroes of faith, they went through what they went through and didn't obtain the promise.
The promise. Mm-hmm. Amen.
What does that mean? It means that they didn't get to see the Messiah.
That's right.
But that does not mean they did not make it to heaven.
All right.
Wow.
That's
right.
Amen.
That's right.
That's not the kind of God we serve.
Amen. Right. Thank you, Lord.
They said, the scripture says that their faith or their belief was imputed to them as what?
Righteousness.
Righteousness.
Amen.
But he has something better for us.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What do you mean,
Jesus,
Bishop?
Thank you, Lord.
He know where to put everybody.
Yes.
Sure enough does.
Amen.
Amen.
He know what dispensation we all belong in.
Yes.
That's right.
I have been dead a long time.
Long time ago, long time. Wouldn't have made it long.
Before I'd be a slave, I'd be
That's right. buried in my grave.
Many of us say that. I couldn't have been a slave. God knew I couldn't
He knew. He knew.
Nobody want to hear what I'm saying.
I hear you.
So I'm not putting her in that dispensation.
Thank God for mercy and grace.
Why? Because I have destiny.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
So he didn't put me in a situation where somebody had to spit in my face.
Truth.
Thank you, Lord.
He didn't let me grow up in the South in Mississippi. Down there in Alabama.
Jesus.
Where I didn't have any problem at that time using profanity.
Jesus.
And talking back.
Uh-huh.
He didn't let me grow up there. He let me grow up in Brooklyn, New York.
Yes.
Bed-Stuy. Thank you, Lord.
Well, because I had destiny.
Yes, thank you.
God knows where to put everybody in what dispensation. Why? Because God has a plan for us. Touch yourself and say, God has a plan for me.
God has a plan for me.
Thank you, Lord.
He knew where to place us so that he can get the most out of us.
Amen.
The best out of us.
Amen.
I'm in his A plan.
Amen.
I don't feel like preaching this morning.
Preach.
God put me here in this century so that I can be the best me that I can possibly be.
Yes.
And can I tell you something? In my earlier life, I wasn't
Amen.
Even knowing that Jesus Christ had died for my sins, I was the worst me I could be.
Anybody hear me?
I was doing my thing. I was the worst me. Even though I grew up in the church and I knew that Jesus Christ was the way, I was still the worst me. But that's what I'm talking about. Something better.
Better, Lord.
Even though I was the worst me, I didn't die the worst me.
Thank God. Thank you, Lord.
Thank God.
Back in the Old Testament, you